Hi, dear friends and subscribers of Cricket Happenings. Once again, welcome to the daily cricket show on YouTube, the Cricket Happening Show. Well, in this Cricket Happening Show, what you are going to look at, you are only going to look at some cricket news. But there is one match which I'll be talking about, and that is the tour game which is happening right now. Just before the Test series, it's a real warm-up for the Sri Lankans, and Sri Lankans are doing pretty well there. This is a match which is going on between Sri Lanka and Northamptonshire, and Sri Lanka have put up a massive total on the board. After batting first, they have raised 558 runs for 8 declared. This was the match which was happening in Northampton. Right now, the situation at tea in Northamptonshire in this first-class match which is being played here is that Sri Lankans declared at the score of 558 for 8 declared. Kaushal, Silva was retired hurt, in the sense Kaushal Silva, as you know, is a real, for me, is like a pocket transistor of batting, because whenever I see Kaushal Silva, I can remember of only one person as far as Sri Lanka is concerned, and that is Ramesh Kalivitharna. We all remember that the big hitting when the One Day International started, where you had to take advantage of the power play, then we had somebody in that mold, and Kaushal Silva is not a very aggressive player. But whenever I see him, it really reminds me of Ramesh Kalivitharna, who was an able partner for Sanjay Jayasurya, and they were the ones who created a revolution as far as big hitting is concerned in the power play overs. In the sense, the field was up. What I wanted to really convey is that during the One Day International, before the power play and everything came up, it was a matter of having the field up in the initial overs, which was that was the time I do remember that Jayasurya and Ramesh Kalivitharna, who actually really took a full toll of the opposition's bowling in the One Day Internationals. So that was it. So Kaushal Silva, we have already seen what a precocious talent he is. Not only that, let me tell you, Kaushal Silva is a complete bundle. It's a real complete package, because one saw him against Pakistan, and the way he batted, oh, definitely he's earmarked for the future. There is no doubt about it. The way he plays, a compact defense, precisely, very, very good technique to deal with the balls, go outside the off stump, and also plays the short ball well. And he's a fine prospect for Kaushal Silva, and he's showing that why, even though if you look at this bowling attack from the Northamptonshire bowlers, doesn't give a sort of a menacing look to it. With Willie is a good bowler, no doubt about that. Crook, then they have Barrett, Coetzer, White. So I wouldn't say this is, but still, I thought Kaushal Silva has played a good hand here. He made 152 with 21 fours and 2 sixes, and he is definitely a test prospect, there's no doubt about it. And we also saw one more century coming in from Lahiru Thirimanne, who also played beautifully, I thought, to make 156 with 14 fours and 2 sixes. After that, Prasanna Jayawardhan, Chandimal got a good knock of 47 with 7 fours, 25 chipping in from Prasanna Jayawardhan, the wicketkeeper. With 4 fours, another wonderful test batsman, I thought. Kushal Pereira, Tisra Pereira, hitting 59 with 5 fours and 4 sixes of just 70 deliveries. Dhamika Prasad was 27 of 22 balls, 4 fours and 1 6, Velagatra not out 5. So 558 for 8 wickets declared, the Sri Lankans against Northamptonshire. David Willie, 12 overs, 2 minutes, none for 39, but Crook was pretty effective. 3 for 98 is returns. We had 1 for 78 for Kyle Coetzer, 2 for 55 for Matthew Spriegel, and Coke 2 for 46. As far as the Northamptonshire reply is concerned, is that right now it's tea time, and the score is 65 for 2. In fact, Nuwan Pradeep had already, in fact, Kettlebro was LBW bowled Chanaka Velagadra, the left-arm seamer, for a duck, and Peters was sent back to the pavilion by Nuwan Pradeep. We had him edging behind the stumps to the Prasanna Jayawardhan, the wicketkeeper, for 5. And currently, Richard Levy is the one who has been doing majority of the scoring in a knock of 65 for 2. His share being an unbeaten 53, on which he's batting right now, of just 41 deliveries and 9 fours. We all know Richard Levy. Richard Levy is a South African, and he's not in I mean, he has not been very consistent, so he doesn't actually find a place in the South African mix of things. But he's a very, very, very dangerous player, let me tell you that. So it's Richard Levy who is doing all the scoring there. He's not out on 53 and a score of 65 for 2 for Northamptonshire. Kyle Coetzer is giving him company, not out on 4. And well, I'm not going to go into much of this detail, so this is what I wanted to talk about. So this is a tour game which is happening just before the test series start between Sri Lanka and England. Just keeping the topic on the Sri Lanka England issue, well, the news which is coming in is that Sri Lanka, England would be touring Sri Lanka in the month of November and December, where they will be playing 7 one-day internationals and 5 reserve days are kept. As you know, Sri Lanka normally, we have seen that on subcontinent conditions, in the sense, Sri Lanka has a lot of rain, and you know, that's the reason they have reserved 5 reserve days. So I think that's a very, very good step, I thought, by the Sri Lankan cricket board in consonance with the English cricket board, that they have decided to give 5 reserve days for the matches, considering the weather conditions there in Sri Lanka. Well, now let's get on to some Australian cricket news. Now, Australian cricket news, as far as Australian cricket news is concerned, well, the Australia A matches are going to be starting, and they, I mean, these are going to be the A teams which are going to clash against India A in South Africa, which is going to happen in July and August. And what Australia has done is they have named captain James Faulkner. They feel that James Faulkner is a man who could be a future captain of Australia. So what they have done is they have actually given him the reins for the 4-day matches against India 11 and also against South African 11 in Townsville. So James Faulkner has been named captain of the 4-day matches, and the as far as the 1-day matches are concerned, which is going to be played at Darwin and Palmerston, Cameron White has been named the captain. Well, the Australia A squad consists of James Faulkner, Cameron Boyce, who is a very good leg spinner, Ben Cutting, Alex Doolan, Peter Forrest, Josh Hazlewood, Moises Enriquez, Phil Hughes, Getson, Chris Lynn, Mitchell Marsh, Kendrick. And these are the players, as you know, the A teams are the ones which actually slowly but surely make their way into the test squad. So there are a lot of test hopefuls there in that particular squad. One can look at Alex Doolan. We all know he has already played some test matches. He's been pretty impressive against England. Peter Forrest has made a lot of test matches. Josh Hazlewood has not played test matches, but definitely knocking on the doors, one could say. But he's a pretty, pretty good one-day bowler. He's a miserly bowler. He won't give much to the batsman to really, really score off. Moises Enriquez, we all know about Moises Enriquez. He has played a lot of cricket for Australia. Phil Hughes, we all know about it. Chris Lynn is the new kid on the block who can really hit the ball a long way, and he's a real treat to watch. Mitchell Marsh is also a very, very bits and good bits and pieces all-rounder. Kane Richardson has played in the Indian Premier League. Chad Sayers, Sam Whiteman is the wicketkeeper. So these are the this is the team which has been selected to play India A and South Africa A. And also, as far as one-day matches are concerned, well, they have Callum Ferguson. They have almost the same competition, but a bit of different changes, which I'm not really, really going to dwell on. And let's have a look at some other cricket news there. As far as other cricket news is concerned, this news is coming in from West Indies, where the other day I said that West Indies named their squad to take on New Zealand. That is, when, as you know, New Zealand are in West Indies right now, and for the test matches, they have actually added one more person into the squad. They have gone for Jason Holder. So Jason Holder has been included into the West Indies squad. So that is some news which is coming in. Well, AB de Villiers, as the other day we saw that Hashim Amla is the new test captain of South Africa. AB de Villiers definitely has felt hard done by, but he has, as a great sportsman, even though, I mean, what I like about AB de Villiers, he has come out in a very, very frank, free and frank manner by saying that he definitely feels a bit grieved that he couldn't actually lay his hands on the captaincy of the test team for South Africa. But nevertheless, he has said that, you know, he would be giving great support to Hashim Amla, who has been picked up. So that is a great, a good sportsman spirit which is shown, and that's very, very important for cricket, because team spirit, the spirit of cricket is very, very important in cricket, because the teams can really, really crumble if there could be misunderstandings. So one only hopes, I mean, one really knows that the Hashim Amla, the captain of South Africa, has some very, very good backing from all the South African players. As you know, Hashim Amla, even in his normal life, he's a real, real gentleman to the core. And it would be very, very good to see how Hashim Amla captains the South African team amidst a lot of experienced persons already there. He has been getting good support with Jack Scales, J.B. de Villiers, Smith, everybody supporting him in this endeavor as far as captaincy is concerned. Well, dear fans and subscribers, I'm trying to see whether there's anything else that I could really, really talk on. Well, I don't think today there's not going to be much, but let me have a look at this particular game. Yes, after tea time, players definitely started here in Northamptonshire, where Livy is staying on 53, but Kyle Coetzer has hit a boundary. He has gone on to 8. But I think it's a very good workout for the Sri Lankan batsmen. They have had some good knocks here, and that should be something which would augur well for them, considering that the test series is about to start. So I think that will be something that they will be very, very happy about, as they put up a very huge score on the board. Well, dear fans and subscribers, there's nothing else to really, really talk about. As I said, it has always been a pleasure to share my views on this cricket happening show. I mean, I can only say my pleasure is only increasing by the day every time I sit over here in my cricket studios dole out this cricket happening show to all my 390 friends and subscribers. Well, once again, thanks all for your tremendous support to the show. Keep it going, and your host Ram is always there to entertain you on this cricket happening show. Until then, it's goodbye. Thank you.